Philly Police Department's at it again. What a police department they have out in Philly. So this is 20-year-old Samir Ahmad, who's a Philadelphia sheriff's deputy that was hired in February. He was fired and arrested, or February 2018, not of this year, but was fired and arrested earlier this month for allegedly selling methamphetamine and guns to an FBI informant, including two guns allegedly used in the ambush at Roxborough High School last month. If convicted, Ahmad faces a maximum of 15 years in prison for what's been done there. The current sheriff, Rochelle Bilal, said in a statement after his arrest was announced that Ahmad joined prior to Bilal taking over elected office. U.S. Attorney Jacqueline C. Ramiro also issued a statement on the deputy's arrest. As alleged, Samir Ahmad had abused his authority to the greatest extent possible. As a sworn law enforcement officer, the defendant was allegedly illegally selling firearms on the street to at least one person who was not permitted to possess them, adding fuel to the already incendiary fire of deadly gun violence in the city of Philadelphia. Federal prosecutors allege two of the guns Ahmad sold to the FBI informant on October 13th were involved in the Roxborough High School shooting after a football scrimmage that killed 14-year-old Nicholas Elizalde. Here's Nicholas's photo. On September 27th, at least four individuals opened fire on a group of teams leaving the scrimmage. Five teens were shot, but Nicholas was fatally wounded. Philadelphia Police Commissioner Danielle Outlaw, yes, her name is really Outlaw, also released a statement on Ahmad's arrest, calling the charges incredibly disturbing and alleged outrageous conduct that stands in stark contrast with everything society expects from law enforcement officers. So I want to pause here and just address that, you know, this was someone who came into law enforcement, and so frequently we see the police overlooking working class communities and communities of color. And then when you have these members enter the police force, why is it that it's so frequently officers of color that are held accountable, but white officers are not? Really just shocking here. The FBI was involved with this. I'm sure the FBI has better things to be up to. But nevertheless, you know, we can't accept corruption wherever it happens, but in the eyes of the law, people who are people of color, people who are black, are treated very differently from white people. That includes those within law enforcement. Something else about the Philadelphia Police Department that many officers were participating in. Last month, NBC 10 Philadelphia found that for more than a decade, if Philadelphia police officers made a typo or were unable to record a precise location for a crime committed in the city, the department would mark the incident with GPS coordinates inside Disney World in Florida, specifically the area behind Cinderella's castle known as Fantasyland. It became the default location for inaccurate crime data, and if they entered nothing at all, it would end up being marked as Disney World, Florida, despite them serving in Philadelphia. The NBC 10 investigators learned that over the past 6 years, more than 5,000 crimes, including 16 arsons, homicides, and 298 auto thefts, were plotted to Disney World. No other location within city limits has more recorded Philadelphia crime. The department's director of research and analysis, Kevin Thomas, said he had not heard of the Disney World coordinates policy until NBC 10 brought it to his attention. But after he learned about the practice, he asked others in the department who said the choice map to certain crimes to Disney World was made more than 10 years ago. The location was chosen intentionally so that bad data would not muddle Philadelphia crime stats, he said. But to bring it back to the police selling things and making a profit, this was someone who was a member of the community in Philadelphia who became, you know, the deputy sheriff. And it almost seems like if you can't beat him, join him situation, because police have been robbing the community for quite some time. Let's get into asset forfeiture. This is according to the Institute for Justice's third edition of Policing for Profit, which was released in 2020. And it presented the largest ever collection of state and federal forfeiture data, which is when the police take items from people. 17 million data points covering 45 states, the District of Columbia, and the federal government. These data show forfeiture is a massive nationwide problem. Since 2000, states and the federal government have forfeited at least $68.8 billion that we know of. Not all states provided full data, so this figure drastically undercounts property taken from people through forfeiture. But $68.8 billion, these are police officers taking things of value from the community, some of them selling them. I'm sure this is not the first case of that happening. Rayyvana?
Yeah, I'm disappointed to learn that what I thought was the happiest place on earth is apparently just descending into chaos and crime. Mickey Mouse really needs to get on the job and clean up his streets. But regarding him selling the weapon that was then used in a school shooting, so we know about this case, but it begs the question, how often are police officers and sheriffs involved in selling drugs, selling weapons, selling things that they obtained through their job as a police officer to the public involved in these crimes that we don't hear of? How often is it covered up by these police departments because they don't want to have some sort of, you know, some sort of scandal, some sort of controversy? How many times are police officers protected by their police department and not held accountable for these crimes that they're involved in? I think it must be a lot because we don't hear about a lot of these cases, but from what I know through research, what I know from people who work in civilian accountability for police officers, police departments, that it is much more systemic than this. I mean, you have the LA Sheriff's Department where members are in white supremacist gangs involved in crime and extensive cover-ups. You know, so we have a story where light was shed on the situation and there was accountability, but it's just one step. We need to continue to call for accountability across all police departments in the United States.
Yeah, it's shocking. As someone who used to work in data, like if you put in an incomplete address and it's not fully accurate, they should probably save that data instead of saving Disney World. Because if your intent is to protect and serve the community, don't you want to remember where violent crimes are happening instead of logging Disney World? Oh, is it the case that they're not there to protect and serve the community? Yeah, maybe. Sounds right to me. All right.